hey guys, how's it going? Well, I'm back with some more patches for the Line 6 Helix. Now, these aren't going to be custom artist patches or anything like that. I had this idea to see if it was possible to maybe recreate the sound of some really sought-after boutique amps. So, when I started this project, I didn't think it was going to work, but I said, well, I'll give it a try. So, the first one I tried to simulate is a Trainwreck Express amp. And once I got the level of the drives correct and close to the sound as I could using the existing Helix preamps and cabs that I needed to use, then I created my special Sound Imprint IR. And that's the whole secret to this next batch of patches that I'm fixing to release. So I was able to simulate the sound of that Trainwreck Express amp. Everything from the rolling back of the volume where it cleans up really nice to full-on distortion. It's got all of the harmonic content that the original amp sound has, and even with the harmonic feedback and everything, which I'll demonstrate. Now, just to be clear, now these are not Line 6 amps, okay? These are simulations of these famous boutique amps that I've created using my special custom Sound Imprint IR and the existing Helix preamps and cabs, okay? Now I've got a long list of these things that I've simulated, just to name a few right off the bat. Like I said, the Trainwreck Express, I've simulated the sound of a Dumble Overdrive Special and a 1965 Fender Basement Blackface, and a long list of others. I'm not going to go into all of that right now, but my plan is this: to release one video per day for the next 10 days, and after that I'll release the patches and they'll be available to you guys. Now the recording process was as follows: XLR out of the Helix right into my computer's audio interface, which is a Focusrite 2i4 recorded stereo. And then I also split a quarter inch line out of the Helix into my new Firehawk 1500, which is right there on the floor by me. And you're going to hear some really cool feedback tones in these patches. That's the sound you're going to get when you're using an amp. Now, I've tried it with a couple of these bad boys behind me going into the effects return and through the 412 cab. They sound great. They really do. I've also sent these to a couple of other people when I first did the train wreck, and I said, what does this sound like? And they said, yeah, it sounds pretty much like the original. So let's see what I can do here with these patches. Now, I'm going to play a short 15 to 20 second clip of the original amp, an isolated guitar track playing the original amp sound. And then I'm going to fade into me playing, I'm going to try to play the same riff, another 20 seconds of my actual patch. That way you'll be able to hear how close they are with no music, pretty much no effects or anything, just if anything, maybe room effects, maybe some room reverb. So, and then after those two little 20 second segments of the original amp sound and my simulation patch, then I'm going to go into about a 2 or 3 minute noodling session where I will go through all of the snapshots. Each one of these simulations of these amps will have 4 snapshots on the bottom row, and which are all going to be varying degrees of gain, okay, starting with snapshot 1, 2, 3, and 4, and snapshot 4 is usually always going to be a lead sound, which will add a little bit of delay, a little bit of reverb, and it'll also boost the level of the patch at least 5 to 7 dB. And then on the top 4 rolls, you'll have different effects on and off that you can add at any time. So that's how this whole thing is going to work. So for the first one I decided to do, which is the one I'm most proud of and the one I really think sounds incredibly close, is my simulation of a Dumble Overdrive Special. So without further ado, guys, check this out.